My name is Edward Marquez. My position is deputy mayor, basically the CFO for the county. Started in the county January of 77 as internal auditor. And I my first 3 years with the county was at various steps in that auditor one, auditor two, auditor three. I started, I guess, around 1980. Famous, the accounting system had been put in the year before and was blowing up. And I was assigned to work at the with the finance department to try to reconcile our back then 108 bank accounts, and which were 6-8 months overdue. After a little while there, the finance director offered me a job as an accountant for out there, and I was put in. Basically had a group of 18-20 accountants under me when I walked in the door. And over the next few years, I progressed to becoming controller and then finance director. And I was finance director for 10 years there. Total 20 years at the county before I left the county to go over to the city of Miami as a city manager. I lasted there 1 year. And after that, I went into the private sector as an investment banker, financial advisor. Did that for 7 years or thereabouts. Then Merritt Sternheim was a school superintendent. He invited me to help him out at the school board. Worked there for about close to 2 years. Merritt had left. We had a new superintendent, and he wanted to bring in his own CFO. So I went back to the investment banking group where I was at. Did another 8 years there, and then the mayor Mayor Jimenez was running for mayor, he and I kept on running into each other, and he suggested I come to work for him. He had worked for me when I was at the city. He was fire chief, and he basically liked my style of management. So that's it. I came back here, and I've been here now for close to, I guess, 10 years, going on 11, with Mayor Jimenez's administration. A regular day starts with a schedule that's planned, and that totally goes out of whack before the end of the day. We react. You know, I'm scheduled in meetings all the time, and our meetings are fairly flexible. If the mayor wants to meet with me, I drop everything and be there to help solve whatever he wants worked on. Otherwise, it's meetings run long, and then we have incoming, and that's, you know, things that come out of the blue that wrecks our day. Or helps every day. My management style is basically I delegate a lot. Okay, I ask a lot of questions, and I consider myself a very good listener. In meetings, I generally keep order, making sure that we just keep moving along, and I try to keep one person talking at a time. But everyone gets to say, you know, some of the best ideas that you can get can come from the least expected of places when you're throwing things up against the wall trying to solve problems. What things do? I double check a lot. Once given a set of numbers or a contract, I'll read through it, or I'll start analyzing the numbers and playing what ifs with my mind. I don't keep a ton of numbers in my head. After all these years, it's more of a feel for how numbers flow, and I can visualize the movement, and I work up summary spreadsheet for myself to verify what I'm reading or being told. So it's just after all these years, I pretty much have a handle on what needs to be done, and I have developed a fair amount of intuition. When I was at the county, I was the finance director. And I was asked by then Mayor Joe Carollo to come on over and help him out. At that point in time, the city had an interim manager, Merritt Sternheim. He went out there for about 3 months, 4 months, and he invited a bunch of people from the private sector as well as county management people to go review the state of the books of the city. And they came out to report. I started in November '96 at the city, and as I was coming in, Stern was making his formal final report to the board, and it was a $68 million deficit. in a budget size that, if I recall right, was about $350-400 million. So that's a huge hole budgetarily. But the worst thing was that they had done cash flow projections, and it kind of indicated that they were going to run out of cash come March, April time frame. And again, this is in November, March, April time frame, and that's after spending restricted money, bond proceeds for operations. When I hit the ground, the first thing I did was basically talking to the state for assistance. I declared an emergency without the board's approval, but I was city manager, a strong form of government at that point in time. So that allowed the Lieutenant Governor Buddy McKay, at the behest of the governor, to come on down and form an oversight group. And I negotiated a contract with the state for measured oversight of the city. And that gave us resources, review resources, attorneys to review documents. I was, along with Mayor Carollo, got the private sector to commit professionals to look at different areas for the city. The city didn't have an inventory of land, for instance. So there was a number of steps that we went through over the course of the year. We balanced the books. I developed a five-year plan, which was actually incorporated the month after I left. And that was used to bring the city out of, they followed the plan and they got out of harm's way financially over a period of years. But it's just, it was a team effort. Carlos Jimenez was the fire chief. He was doing code enforcement, trying to raise money at my behest. Mayor Carollo was out there working on a transaction where we sold the land under the American Arena to the county so that we had an infusion of cash. So yeah, it was a heady year, to say the least. But I'm very proud of that time.